Hello everyone. Welcome to Let's Know the Botany series, where you will get everything about plant sciences. Please like, share and subscribe the channel. Myself, Dr. Sujit Jadhav, Assistant Professor, Department of Botany, SBR College, Masvad, Taluka Man, District Satara. Today, the objectives of this particular lecture series, they are something like this. That is to make a complex process converted to simple and understandable language to the common students, designing the entire series with different graphical solutions, the information availability to the graduate and undergraduate students of the botany. Today in this particular lecture, we are going to discuss about molecular markers. The two molecular markers we are going to discuss are RFLP and RAPD. But before starting with the discussion of RFLP and RAPD, one should understand what these molecular markers are. Molecular markers are specific fragments of DNA that can be identified within the whole genome. Molecular markers are found at specific locations of the genome. They are used to flag the position of a particular gene or the inheritance of a particular characteristic. In a genetic cross, the characteristics of interest will usually stay linked with the molecular markers. Thus, individuals can be selected in which the molecular marker is present, since the marker indicates the presence of the desired characteristics. Molecular genetic markers can be divided into two classes. The first one, that is molecular markers which detect variation at the DNA level, such as nucleotide changes, deletion, duplication, inversion, and or insertion. And the another class is biochemical markers which detect variation at the gene product level, such as changes in proteins and amino acids. Some commonly used types of genetic markers, they are as like RFLP, that is restriction fragment length polymorphism, then random amplification of polymorphic DNA. These two markers, we are going to discuss them in this particular lecture. Then another markers like simple sequence length polymorphism, then amplified fragment length polymorphism, then single nucleotide polymorphism, simple sequence repeat is there, single feature polymorphism is there, restriction site associated DNA markers are there, and another one, that is diversity arrays technology. First of all, we will start with the discussion of restriction fragment length polymorphism, that is RFLP. In molecular biology, restriction fragment length polymorphism is a technique that exploits variation in homologous DNA sequences known as polymorphisms in order to distinguish individuals, populations, or species, or to the pinpoint the locations of genes within a sequence. Simply, the variations in the restriction DNA fragments length between individuals of a species is called as RFLP. The basic technique of identifying such restriction fragment length polymorphisms involve fragmenting a sample of DNA by a restriction enzyme, which can recognize and cut DNA wherever a specific short sequence occurs in a process known as restriction digest. The resulting DNA fragments are then separated by length through a process known as agarose-gel electrophoresis and transferred to a membrane via the Southern blot procedure. Hybridization of the membrane to a labeled DNA probe then determines the length of the fragments which are complementary to the probe. Restriction fragment length polymorphism is a genetic marker. It is a technique that exploits variations in homologous DNA sequences. It is useful in study of genomic DNA sequences. This technique has been developed for chromosome mapping of mice, maize, tomato, rice, human, etc. In this technique, DNA is digested with restriction enzyme. In this method, 1 to 10 loci are detected. As far as principles of RFLP has been concerned, if two organisms differ in the distance between sites of cleavage of a particular restriction endonuclease, the length of the fragments produced will differ when the DNA is digested with a restriction enzyme. The similarity and differences of the patterns thus generated can be used to differentiate species and even strains from one another. Restriction fragment length polymorphism is a technique invented in 1984 by an English scientist, Alex Jeffries, during research into hereditary diseases. It is used to analysis of unique patterns in DNA fragments in order to genetically differentiate between organisms. If two organisms differ in the distance between sites of cleavage of a particular restriction in the nucleus, the length of the fragments produced will differ when the DNA is digested with a restriction enzyme. The similarity and differences of the patterns thus generated can be used to differentiate species and even strains from one another. These are some steps involved in the RFLP, that is genomic target DNA isolation, followed by digestion with restriction enzymes, then gel electrophoresis, followed by DNA in millions of restriction fragments fractionated in the gel by molecular marker weight. This DNA transferred out of the gel onto a membrane filter, southern hybridization, then autoradiography, and at the end, visualization of RFLP bands. One by one, we will analyze these steps. The first step is collection of samples, that is, DNA is extracted from the available tissue samples. Then restriction digest. The DNA in each sample is digested with the same restriction enzyme. Then gel electrophoresis, that is, the digested fragments are run in polyacrylamide gel electrophoresis or agarose gel electrophoresis to separate the fragments on the basis of length or size or molecular weight. Then it is followed by denaturation. The gel is placed in sodium hydroxide solution for denaturation so that single-stranded DNA is formed. Then it is followed by blotting. The single-stranded DNA obtained are transferred into charged membrane, that is nitrocellulose paper, by the process called as capillary blotting or electroblotting. That step is followed by baking and blocking. The nitrocellulose paper transferred with DNA is fixed by autoclaving. Then the membrane is blocked by using bovine serum albumin or casein to prevent binding of labeled probe non-specifically to the charged membrane. Then hybridization and visualization. This labeled RFLP probe is hybridized with DNA on the nitrocellulose paper. The RFLP probes are complementary as well as labeled with radioactive isotopes, so they form color bands under visualization by autoradiography. Now we will discuss about different applications of RFLP. RFLP has been used for several genetic analysis applications to determine the status of genetic diseases such as cystic fibrosis in an individual, to determine or confirm the sources of DNA samples such as in paternity tests or criminal investigations, in genetic mapping to determine combination rates that show the genetic distance between the loci, and to identify a carrier of a disease-causing mutation in a family. There are some disadvantages of RFLP. As it becomes almost obsolete with the advent of relatively simple and less expensive DNA profiling technologies such as the polymerase chain reaction, that is PCR, as well as RFLP procedure requires numerous steps and it takes weeks to yield results, while techniques such as PCR can amplify target DNA sequences in a mere few hours. Since its invention, additionally, RFLP requires a large DNA sample, the isolation of which can be laborious and time-consuming process. In contrast, PCR can be amplified minutes amounts of DNA in a matter of hours. Then the another technique of molecular markers, that is RAPD, random amplified polymorphic DNA. This particular technique is a PCR-based technique for identifying genetic variations. It involves the use of a single random choice based, that is arbitrary, primer in a PCR reaction, resulting in the amplification of many discrete DNA products. The technique was developed independently by two different laboratories. Williams et al. In 1990 named it as RAPD, where Welch and MacLean in 1990 named it as a APPCR, that is arbitrary primed PCR. RAPD detects the nucleotide sequence polymorphisms in a DNA amplification based assay using only a single primer of arbitrary nucleotide sequence. Here a single species of primer binds to the genomic DNA at two different sites on opposite strands of the DNA template. If these priming sites are within an amplifiable distance of each other, a discrete DNA product is produced through thermocyclic amplification. As far as principles of RAPD are concerned, RAPD is a PCR-based molecular marker technique. Single short oligonucleotide primer is arbitrarily selected to amplify a set of DNA segments distributed randomly throughout the genome. These are different steps involved. This is the hierarchy of steps involved in it. One by one, we will discuss about all these steps. First step is extraction of DNA. That is, selected species of DNA is isolated first of all. Then an excess of deoligonucleotide is added to it. Then repeated cycles of DNA denaturation, renaturation and DNA replications are followed. During this process, the deoligonucleotide will pair with homologous sequence present at different locations in the DNA. DNA replication extend the deoligonucleotide and copy the sequence continuous with the sequence with which the selected oligonucleotide has paired. The repeated cycles of denaturation, renaturation and DNA replication will amplify the sequence of DNA. In the next step, the amplification will take place only of those regions of the genome that has the sequence complementary to the deoligonucleotide at their base end, both ends. After several cycles of amplifications, the DNA is subjected to gel electrophoresis, and at the end, the amplified DNA will form a distinct band. It is detected by ethidium bromide staining and visible under ultraviolet light. There are some different applications of RAPD, that is, it is useful to evaluate for genetic relationship analysis between native breeds and native and exotic breeds of livestock. Species differentiation can be possible using RAPD technique. For example, differentiation between different strains of chicken, turkey, quail and other avian. Genetic diversity or polymorphism can be applied. Germplasm characterization can be followed by RAPD. Genetic structure of population and genome can be possible with the help of RAPD. Then population and evolutionary genetics can be possible, and animal plant microbe interaction can be possible with RAPD. There are few limitations of RAPD also, that is, it mismatches between primer and template may result in the total absence of PCR products as well as in a merely decreased amount of the product. Thus, RAPD results can be difficult to interpret. It is not possible to distinguish whether a DNA segment is amplified from a locus that is heterozygous, that is one copy, or homozygous, that is second copy, as nearly all RAPD markers are dominant. So this is about RFLP and RAPD. RFLP is non-PCR based method. RFLP is based genetic marker method. As compared to other methods, RAPD exhibit reasonable cost, speed and efficiency. And this technique is probably important despite of its reproducibility problem, as RAPD can be done in a moderate laboratory also. So concluding this, we stop here. Thank you. Thank you very much.